Walmart spray paint, 99 cents. We got enough to do both of these here real quick. They're warm, so they'll dry quick on there. Quicker than if it wasn't. There's one. I hit them with that buffing wheel, so they're kind of sanded a little bit. I would not recommend painting anything that's dirty or doesn't have something for that paint to hold on to, like some sanding marks or... Oh my lord, this one's wet. I'm gonna hang it from this wire right here. Hopefully it'll stay there. I'm gonna get some paracord set up. So what is that? This one's gonna, I'm gonna say 6 foot each. And that's 6 foot right there. That's 6 foot. I got me 2 pieces of paracord. I think I'm gonna keep the center in the paracord this time. Find myself pulling up my pants there. Sorry. Where's my, oh, here it is. My electrical tape. Get a good hold of that thing right there like that. I'm gonna put some electrical tape on it. Need something for that paracord to grab hold of. Without it, it can slide and do all kinds of things. I find electrical tape to be really good at stopping it from sliding. It molds to the tape pretty easily, it would seem like. I'm trying to get it in there good. Looks like I got it this time. If I can get one of these things here, I'm gonna find the middle of it. I'm gonna start tying. I go over, I go under and through. Try to land my first knot on one side, and then my second knot, I try to land directly on the other side because it's actually two knots at the same time. It's called a DNA knot. If you wanna watch someone else do it, it's right on YouTube. You cannot miss it. They definitely got better tutorials of how to do this knot than I do. But I do like paracord. I could put a handle on something in just moments that doesn't look bad, that doesn't feel bad, that doesn't mildew. It does melt. But it has the potential to last a long time. Oh. Hope I make it down to the end of the electrical tape. If I did 10 foot, I might have been able to go all the way down to the hole, but I'm not doing that today. I don't know why. I think I want some of that metal exposed this time. Looks like I'm just gonna make it there, guys. One more time, perhaps. I'm not gonna fuss with it too much if it isn't. There it is. Come on, I got you. I had you. Got you nice and tight there. I'm gonna cut you. Then I'm gonna melt you. And get it nice and hot, get it nice and gooply. But you gotta be careful because it gets this stuff, when it gets melted, it's very much hot enough to really burn you. So I recommend a big lick. I recommend that big lick. Here's the other side. I'm just gonna cut it where it's at. I'm gonna give her some melt. and trying not to melt the rest of that stuff. But it can be tough, and that's already dry, so I'm gonna find my buffing wheel again. Look at there, have like an edge or whatever. That a lot, actually. It'd go well in anybody's collection, I don't mind saying. It's nice and sharp, took no time at all. I'm gonna do the same thing to the other one, and I'm gonna have me a nice dual set wherever I put that other one. My lord, I put it somewhere, but I am gonna do the same thing to the other one. Here, check it out real close. Have a nice day, guys. I'm gonna turn her off now.